Okay, my name is Eran, I'm from Mellanox, and today I will present a tool that I recently developed for the kernel. It's called Devlink Elf. It is based on the Devlink tool, which I guess you all, or most of you are familiar with. Okay, so a bit motivation for this. If you ever plugged a NIC into your environment and tried to send some traffic over it, you will most likely saw that eventually, unfortunately, errors will happen. Maybe there are hardware errors, maybe firmware errors, maybe software errors. It's really hard to identify and to tell. And wouldn't it be nice if you, all the components of the driver would just say, I'm okay, it's not me? It would be a great thing that we will have, and that's exactly what Devlink Elf is proposing. So even if eventually we would know that the problem is with, let's say, the TX component of the driver, or maybe with the firmware, and I'm an administrator which is monitoring my cluster, I don't usually know what kind of information I need to provide for the vendor developers in order for them to solve the issue. And most likely I will provide them some kernel logs. And myself as a driver developer, when I'm getting only the kernel logs, usually the problem is not easily seen. Moreover, usually when I want to debug the problem, most likely, or maybe I will need to get some live access to the system. And some customers do not want to share information. They do not want to give me live access. Maybe I have to fly to the customer cluster in order to debug it online. And this is not an easy thing. And if the issue is escalated, then it is very unpleasant thing to do. And the last thing, how do I recover from an error? I need to provide some temporary solution until I'm getting a permanent solution. So today, every vendor has its own tools. Most of them are vendor specific. They are most likely not error oriented, meaning that I need to come to the system to see what are the errors, to find the correct tools or maybe some tools and try them until I will get all the information that I need in order to debug the problem. And the last thing is that even if myself as a cluster administrator have some monitoring over the D message or over some special counters and I'm very happy and satisfied with the situation, if I switch the NIC into some other vendor's NIC, most likely I will need to rewrite all the script by all the scripts again. So what I proposed here is Devlink Elf. Let's talk a bit about its highlights. First of all, it's centralizing the PCI driver's health state. I mean, every PCI driver that is registered to the Devlink can use the Devlink Elf features and provide some information about its health. The flow is generic inside the kernel networking core, inside netcore Devlink, meaning that there is one flow in order to handle the errors and in order to fetch the dumps and everything, so you don't need to rewrite it all over again. It's compound of the driver's reporters, meaning that you need to just write a reporter that I will tell about it soon. It has the ability to do real-time error detection, meaning when the error happened, then the Devlink get immediate update about the fact that there is an error. Every reporter can provide some callbacks for error recovery, for diagnose, and for dump. We'll talk soon what you can dump. And all of them are being controlled by the Devlink Elf core. We maintain statistics per reporter, so you can know that how many errors occurred, how many recover operation has undergone via this reporter and for this driver. you can have real-time health status indication. This is what I told at the motivation part. You could just come and see that you have 10 reporters per NIC, and all of them are healthy, or maybe one of them is in error state. You can do some operation from user space. I mean, you can come to the system and say, I want to get a live diagnose of the error, or maybe I want to take a dump because I need it now and not when the error occurred. So you can do it with very simple commands that I will show next. The Devlink Health is logging almost all of his activities into the kernel debug tracing buffer, so you can come later and see exactly what happened and get some more information. And last thing, it was accepted into kernel 5.1, and the user space is already available in IP route to next, meaning that you just need to write your reporters part and you are getting it immediately. Okay, so let me introduce the reporter. In this presentation, I will show you some struct and some APIs. So the reporter will always be in red. The operation will be in blue, and the F message that I will describe later will be in some yellow gold colored. So the reporter is compound of its operations, some pointer for his dump, some configuration attributes which are only controlled from the user space, so have out of box value, and some statistics that that we maintain. The important thing here is that all of these tracks is defined in devlink.c, meaning that the driver could not access them, he cannot read them. And this is, we did it in order to have full control by the devlink. Okay, so in order to create a devlink, you need to provide some operations, you need to provide the name, you need to provide a recover callback, a dump callback, and a diagnose callback. And afterwards, you just call Devlink Health Reporter, Reporter Create, and you get back a reporter. I mean, you provide the operations, but the reporter itself is allocated inside the Devlink. You can later destroy it. And when you are creating it, you can provide some priv pointer. You can give your net device pointer, you can give some internal priv pointer, you can give whatever you want, and the devlink will provide it to you in some with the callbacks. You can see it here in the for the recover and the dump, you will get a private context. Okay, one more nice thing that I provided here is assume that you are having a reporter that his state is not healthy because he had some error. Afterwards, let's say for example that you have an SQ that is not transmitting data because there is a problem with the hardware object of it. So later on you can just, for example, do if config down, interface down and interface up, and then we have opened a new SQ, so the errors with the previous SQ are no longer relevant. So in that case, I provided an API to do some direct state update, and I will show how I use it in the MLX5 Ethernet driver. Okay, one more nice thing here, as I said, that there is a kernel tracing buffer mechanism. The devlink has three functions which logs into this buffer. You can enable them. If you enable them, then you will get back your viable information. Every time that there is an error, it will print into this log. Every time that the recover was aborted, it will also print into this log. And in addition, every time that you did direct state update, it will also print into this log. And the important note here is that if you did not do any of these enablements, the Devlink Health will still work perfectly. It just won't log into this buffer. Maybe you don't want to log into this buffer, that's fine. But the important thing is that there are some built-in operations inside the kernel that you can do, that you can monitor this file and you can see changes. And if, for example, you have some utility and you want to fetch dumps when there is an error, you can just get events from this log, filter them according to your reporter, and that's all. Okay, so the error flow handling. The driver do initiate the error flow. It means the driver can detect multiple errors while it's running, while it sends traffic, while it's doing resource allocation, and once it detect an error, and you have a reporter that knows how to recover or dump or diagnose this error, it just calls the Devlink Health report with the reporter. It can provide a message that will be logged into the kernel debug tracing buffer, and it can provide some private context, which is error-related context. And in my driver, when I have an SQ error, I'm putting inside the context the SQ number. And when I'm getting the recovery operation back from the Devlink, I'm getting a pointer in which the SQ number is written. So I don't have to go and look for the bad SQ, and I don't need to re-figure out what happened. I'm getting all the information that I need, and then I can do a quick recovery. Okay, so first thing that the Devlink is doing is tracing out the message. Afterward, it does a state filtering, and by state filtering, I mean that if the reporter is already in error state because the previous recover did not work, for example, then I don't want to do another recover. I just assume that the recover will not work, and then I am aborting and going out. So this is the state filtering. Afterwards, I'm dumping information with another callback of the reporter. And the last thing that I do, I'm doing a recover in case that the reporter has a recover method. Okay, so when at the beginning I told you that there is some diagnose and dump callbacks. So the most important thing with the diagnose and dump callbacks is that the driver developer has provided some function which is designated to find all the needed information for its own errors. Meaning, for example, you can see here that I want to dump some information which are SQ related. And if I have an error on my TX reporter, then this information is crucial. And if I have an error with the firmware, then this information is not crucial. So I have two different reporters. One of them will print this information, and the other one will, for example, print the firmware information. And when the customer will have a problem with the TX reporter, it will just bring me the dumps of this reporter. So I won't get like tons of information, and I won't know what to look for. And you can write your own reporters and dump any information that you think is crucial for you whenever you are debugging the problem. And what is not crucial, you won't get it back. So we need to find a way to provide those dumps back into the user. So for that matter, we wanted to use the JSON format. So I guess you all are familiar with the JSON format. So the Devlink is providing some empty F message, which is a formatting message. And then if you want to add a new object, you're just calling a special API that I will show that adds an object. If you want to add name, if you want to add value array, all of this is possible with Devlink F message format. And eventually you can create this nice JSON message. And this will be printed by the user space to the screen. And you can see that both dump and diagnose callbacks are getting the F message empty instance. Okay, and this is the API, just to let you know, we won't go over it. Okay, and MLX file reporters today with kernel 5.1, besides the core, I provided one example reporter. It is responsible of two scenarios. One of them is whenever the kernel discovers a TX timeout, you most likely know that it calls your callback for NDO TX timeout, and we replace the entire handling of the NDO TX timeout with my Devlink TX reporter. Before that, we had to discover if there is a real timeout, and we did some reset for the software and for the hardware, but the user could not control any of this. So if I have a customer that do not want to do reset and he prefers the ASCII to be kept with an error state, it could not done it. So today I'm just calling the TX reporter and I'm saying the Devlink, okay, I have a problem. And from that moment on, only the Devlink will control what happens for my TX timeout bug. It will call my dump operation, it will call my recovery operation, and then it will finish, and I will say that the TX timeout was solved, or maybe not solved. And another thing is an example of our data path. Inside our data path, we are getting completions back from the hardware, and those completions can indicate that there is an error with our send queue. And instead of doing some reset or maybe ignore it, I'm giving the Devlink the opportunity to handle it with my TX reporter. And last thing, if I'm closing and reopening the SQs, then I do some direct health state update. In order to tell the Devlink, I don't know what you know. I know that you did not ask me to do a recover, but now I'm healthy. Let's go, let's assume that. Okay. The user API is relatively simple. It starts, all of the operations start with Devlink health prefix. And afterwards, you can run show, diagnose, dump, clear, dump, show, recover, and set. So the first thing, I will show the outputs. We will go over it real fast. You can run Devlink Health Show. You can specify the device and the reporter if you want to, and if not, you can just get everything back. And it shows the state. You can see the reporter's name. You can see if it's healthy or not. You can see how many errors it detected, how many recoveries was asked for. You can see when the last dump was taken. You can see the date and the time. And two more things that you can see here that I did not mention so far is the configuration of the reporter. Today you can configure two things about the reporter. You can configure if you want to do auto recover or not. And it's very good. For example, we had in the past some internal detection that there was an error with the firmware. And the first thing that we do is reset the firmware. And afterwards, the error reoccurred, and then we reset the firmware again. But what the problem was that the firmware did a reset, and it did not resolve the problem. So the first thing that he did is to raise another error. So the customer just faced an infinite loop of firmware reset. And the problem was not fatal, but it could not work with our device due to this error. So all he had to do is to come and configure the firmware reporter auto recovery to off, and then he could work and come to Mellanox and say, listen, I have a problem of some error. If you can just fix it, then fine, but I can still work with the system as is. And the other thing is grace period. For example, if you have an error and you have a recover, but the error happens every minute and you don't want to fix it every minute, you say if it happens one in a day or one in two or once in 2 days, then okay, fix it. So it's called the grace period. But if it happened in less than, for example, this is the this is 20 minutes in a millisecond, and if it happened in less than 20 minutes, just don't recover it because I don't want to keep working in that way. So those are the two out of box, parameters that you can configure for the devlink, for the reporters. If there will be some new ones or new suggestions, of course, that we can add them. We try to do it generic and don't provide a configuration per reporter, because if we start having such thing, it will become like a trash of configuring the driver. So we are keeping it generic. Next command is diagnose. You can just, as I said, ask the reporter to diagnose the system this time. We provide it in a human readable way, like you're seeing here, and in a JSON format. The JSON format is much better for scripts, and the human readable is much better for developers that wants to read it. The next thing is dump show and dump clear. In order to not overload the kernel memory, we are not allowing more than one dump per reporter. So in case that there was an error detection, there is an automatic dump operation, and afterwards it's being saved into the kernel's memory. And if you want to clear the dump, you should do devlink help show, save the dump wherever you want to, and afterwards press devlink help clear. And this, and in the next time that there will be an error, we will do save a new dump. Otherwise, every time that you will do devlink help show, you will get the same dump over and over again. And this is an example of our firmware dump. All you have to do is press dump show and you get all the dumps. And the nice thing here is that before we have the devlink help, if we want to ask the customer to provide us some firmware dump, we had to provide him a vendor-specific tool, most likely not open source, that will do the dump, and he wouldn't like it. Maybe you don't want to put it in a reproduction environment. So now we have some upstream user space tool that he can just run whenever he wants to. And the next thing is recover. You can just ask the reporter to do a recover. The automatic recover is recovering from a specific error. But if, for example, I have 10 SQs and I'm doing I'm calling the devlink help recover reporter and it calls the recover, then I'm expecting it to fix only the SQ that says that is in error state. And if I'm doing it from user space, it means that I want to do a full recover. And in the driver, we have two different implementations. One of them is for error specific, which comes from the driver, and a different recover, which just close all the SQs and reopen them. But it's up to the developers to decide how he wants to use it. And the last command is set. I just talked about it. You can change the out-of-box parameters of the grace period and the auto-recover with whatever you want to. Okay. And now I want to show some nice thing that we did in Hackathon in Mellanox over the Mellanox cloud. We took some dozens of machines. I installed the devlink help utility over them, and you can see every host is one row, and it's very easy for the administrator to see that you have two hosts with error, two hosts with warning. Warning means that there was an error, but it was recovered, and after 2 hours, we switch it to green. It shows the minimal state, meaning that the green means that all of the reporters and all of the NICs are in health state. And red means that there is at least one in error state. And if you click on one host, you can see a row per a reporter and the NIC. And here you can see exactly which NIC was in error state. we added an ability to just click over the reporter and get the dumps. So with that, we just clear the dumps, and it is ready to accept new dumps if an error occurred. Okay, what's next? Not in the presentation, but in the real world. So the first thing is exposure. We have a nice core, which is stable, and only one reporter. I'm not planning to stop here, and I hopefully some other driver developers from different companies will also use it, because I think this utility is great. We have some big plans for it in Mellanox. We have many customers that are eager to get it. So you will most likely see new reporters soon. And the last thing that we are preparing an RFC for the community is the software dumps. I think that it would be really great if I, from the TX reporter, will get like a memory mapping of the software structure of the SQL, not only from the firmware or from the hardware. Usually when you want to debug, you need to use spare or you need to add some special prints in order to get some private context parameters. So if we will be able to have software dumps as part of the kernel with Devlink, it will eliminate the use of debug prints maybe to nothing. That's all. If you have some question, I will be happy to answer. Yeah. You have a mic?
So first of all, I think this is really good work. I would be interested in using it. But one question I have is, did you look into, so sometimes when you have the hardware errors, they lead to software errors and even to kernel crashes. So tying this into KDump, that would be able to pull the errors and provide it to you inside the dump that it provides, would give you a complete package and might also address what you just mentioned in some of the software dumps.
Yeah, actually, can you hear me, right? Actually, we were investigating the KDumps. The KDumps is really good if the kernel crashes. But actually, it's even if the kernel crashes, most likely you won't be able to take the dumps from the devlink and everything. Maybe you will be able to see it in the logs. But if the kernel did not crash, and you just have an error, for example, for TX timeout, then KDump is not so good because you don't want to dump the entire kernel. And usually when you're dumping the kernel, it means that the kernel is no longer working. So we are looking for something more zoomed in. The entire the motivation for using the reporters is when you want something which is just zoomed in into your problem, and fetching all the dump and dumping the entire kernel is too much.
I'm not suggesting triggering KDump whenever you have an error report, but maybe tying in KDump into the collecting just only reporters that have errors.
Okay, that's a good idea. And we will be posting, my colleague will post an RFC for it soon. And if you will be able to see it and give your comments, it would be great. Because those are the things that we actually are trying to solve now.
So we're not going to take any more questions. I'm sorry, because we started a bit late. Where's Florian?
Devlink is great.
Devlink is great! Everybody, come on.
Thank you.